Bermuda 851, turn right, heading 180. Bermuda 14 Papa, turn right 245, report localizer established 27.
It's been a long and grueling now 21 months since the Boeing 737 MAX was first grounded. Thankfully, some 48 hours ago, it took to the skies again with customers on board during a routine flight in Brazil. With the ungrounding order, though, things have progressed greatly in that regard, especially with production restarting for the jet many months ago. If you are unaware, in January of this year, Boeing announced it would stop production of the aircraft simply because they were building too many, the backlog was becoming too severe, and they had no space at any of their facilities to actually store the incomplete Boeing 737 MAXs. In addition, supplies and parts were not able to be transported to them given the current climate of the industry. In recent days, Boeing delivered its first 737 MAX for a significant period of time to none other than United Airlines following the ungrounding order, and signals a period now where they can begin to clear their backlog with customers that are going in also willing to accept the type that they ordered before the crisis first hit them. While the aircraft, though, has been delivered to United Airlines, it will not actually fly with the carrier just yet. Unlike American Airlines and Gol, United Airlines has plans to reintroduce the jet to its operations in the coming year, so 2021. Specifically, we've been given the information that this will be the first quarter, and even then, it's highly unlikely they'll return at the same rapid rate given the current climate and drop-off in travel demand. A spokesperson, thanks to the Seattle Times, commented on the first delivery of the type following many, many long months, saying, "As we begin receiving 737 MAX deliveries from Boeing, we will inspect every aircraft, require our pilots to undergo additional training, reviewed and approved by the FAA, and conduct test flights before we bring these aircraft back into service." While the Boeing 737 MAX family is finally returning to the skies, an upgrading order does not necessarily mean the type can return straight away worldwide. Airlines are currently training, like mentioned in that spokesperson's release, their 737 MAX pilots on flight simulators in order to better understand the aircraft, so when they do fly it in person, they're hopefully prepared to understand the software adjustments that Boeing has been working on to rectify the mishaps of prior incidents since March of 2019. I would like to further add on to that. This is important when understanding other regulators certifying the 737 MAX. Just because, say, they approve it straight away, it doesn't necessarily mean that it'll be flying straight away with all airlines in that said country. For Brazil, they were lucky that Gol is the only operator of the 737 MAX, but immediately we can have a look at the EASA as, if you will, a little case study, where many airlines in there operate the 737 MAX. Not all of them will return to service straight away. There are many other factors that we have to consider, like that of demand, of course, the time it will take to train the pilots in the 737 MAX simulator, whether it would benefit them moving forward to introduce all of them coming back, and also airlines will want to take a look at the aircraft themselves. United Airlines, though, of course, the focus of today's video, in the coming years are still expected to welcome on the likes of the 737 MAX 10, 737 MAX 9, and 737 MAX 8, with currently in its future fleet, the only planned main variant to be missing there is the 737 MAX 7, which is the shortest of the series. What are your thoughts on the first delivery of the 737 MAX in a significant period of time or anything else I mentioned in this video? Feel free to drop your thoughts below, and as always, thank you so much for the continued support. It is greatly appreciated. Take care, and please do continue to stay safe, and I will see you all in the next video.